By syncing Klaviyo to Facebook, you can significantly improve your ad targeting. You can set up audiences that are similar to your existing customers, saving you time and money by targeting people on Facebook and Instagram who are most likely to buy. Hi, I'm Sean. I run Email Experts, and in this video, I'll show you how to connect Klaviyo to Facebook, but also how to make the most of that integration to improve your Facebook ad campaigns. I'll also show you how to set up lead ads, but also explain why I think most brands shouldn't use them. In this video, when I talk about Facebook integration, I'm talking about the Meta advertising network, which includes Facebook and Instagram, but also other ad spots on the network, such as on websites and mobile apps. With the Klaviyo to Facebook integration, you can sync your subscribers and customers in real time into the audience section of the Meta ad network. At the time of recording, Google Ad Network doesn't have the equivalent connection, but we expect that will come in the next 12 months. First, I'll talk about the Facebook audience sync, and then I'll cover lead ads. If you want to jump ahead, we've timestamped the video, so you can use the chapters along the bottom of the video or find timestamps in the description below. So why should you connect Klaviyo to Facebook for advertising? Well, if you've been using Klaviyo, you know that you can make great customer segments based on the data that you directly know about your customers, such as their purchase history and email engagement. The Klaviyo to Facebook integration allows you to take advantage of these segments to build your Facebook audiences. Here's some examples of some different ways that you can build segments in Klaviyo to sync them to Facebook audiences, and we're going to focus on these four. So you can re-engage customers, you can make an audience of customers who haven't given you email permission or have stopped engaging with your emails and reach out to them with ads. You can find new customers, similar to your best customers, with lookalike audiences. You can promote cross-channel campaigns across both email and social media at the same time. And finally, you can exclude your existing subscribers from list growth campaigns. Note that when you're syncing audiences to Facebook, you need to match at least 100 profiles to Facebook to sync the audience. What that means is that the email address someone uses in Klaviyo will need to match a Facebook profile. Since not every email address has a Facebook account associated with it, you'll need more than 100 profiles in any segment that you want to sync to Facebook. And the sweet spot, I recommend at least 500 to 1,000. Before we set up the audiences, I'll show you how to connect Klaviyo to Facebook. First, you need to have access to your Meta / Facebook ad account and your Facebook page profile. I'm logged into the Facebook ad account, the Facebook page admin, and Klaviyo. In Klaviyo, I need to go to integrations. I need to go to all integrations, and I need to search Facebook. I need to connect to Facebook advertising. It'll take me to Facebook where I continue as myself. Note that in this process, you will see all the ad accounts that you have access to. If you're running an agency, I recommend you ask your client to do this step, since you don't want your client seeing other ad accounts you might have access to. So I'll click integrate. In this step, you'll be able to see the ad accounts for other ones you have access to. Select the one that's appropriate to this Klaviyo account. Click connect. Oh, we'll have the audience settings. Now you do need to link one before you can continue on. And continue on, but we can update that in the future. Then we'll also ask you to sync to your Facebook page. And again, you just want to make sure that you're logged into your Facebook page. And we'll connect to the Facebook, we'll connect to the Facebook lead ad list. And that's it. Now you're connected for audience sync and lead ads. What this integration has enabled, when you go into segments and lists within Klaviyo and go to settings, you'll now have the option to sync the list or segment to an audience in Facebook. And I'll show you how to do that in a second. And under lists, you'll also be able to connect lead ads, which we'll get into later. Within a list or segment in Klaviyo, now when you go to settings, you now have this Facebook section here. It says here this list is not currently synced to a Facebook custom audience. You click here to choose an audience to sync with, and you can choose one or you can create a new audience. In this case, I'm going to sync it to this Klaviyo audience too. Often there's a bit of a lag, so in making this video, I've sped up the process, and so I'm just going to sync to this, which I've already done before. So I'm going to sync to this audience, and that's it. Now you can see that this audience here is synced to our Klaviyo audience too. In this example, I've connected it to a list. For segments, it's the same. You just find the Facebook advertising section and you'll have the option there to sync the list or segment to a audience within Facebook, and you can create a new audience. So now when you go into Facebook and go to the audience section of the Facebook Ad Manager, you'll see here now we have Klaviyo Audience 2. It tells us our sync size here, so it's synced enough customers. And so now this is an audience that's ready to use. And the great thing about syncing to a Facebook segment in particular is that it's going to be regularly updated. So the data from Klaviyo will be synced back into Facebook regularly, about every half hour or so. Now I'm going to talk about how you can use the segments and audiences that you sync from Klaviyo into your Facebook audiences. So in most circumstances, what you'll do is you'll get to the creating an ad section. So here's just an example lead ad set. And when you're editing the lead ad section, you can choose your audience and it will just be listed in here. So that's how you set up a segment within Klaviyo and then sync that as an audience to Facebook for your advertising. It's also how you select that audience for your Facebook ads. So now I'll go through the specific examples that I talked about before. Re-engage, new customers, cross-channel, and lookalike. So let's make a re-engagement segment. So within Klaviyo, click create list or segment, click segment, and I recommend giving them a consistent name. So to re-engage customers, we want to find anybody who has opened an email 0 times in the last 90 days. And who has opened an email at least once. And so if you sync this to your Facebook audiences, you click here to choose an audience to sync with, and you can choose one or you can create a new audience. There are two types of campaigns that you could run to this audience. One is an ad that mirrors what your emails are doing so that customers who aren't opening your emails are still seeing that creative. And the second is that you could use this as a new lead capture campaign because it's possible that some of these subscribers have another email address or a different email address. And so running a promo or attracting them to sign up to your mailing list again could re-engage them or get them to sign up with an email address that they're actually actively using. So next we're going to set up an audience to attract new customers using Facebook, but using your existing customers as a template for the type of customers that you want Facebook to try and find. So rather than setting up your target audiences in Facebook, you use your existing customers as a template. So there's two different ways that you can do this. You can either target customers based on their lifetime spend or on the number of purchases that they've made. And this will depend on you as a brand as to which one you want to use, or maybe try either of them and see which one's going to be most effective. So there's two ways that you can do this, and they're both pretty straightforward. The first one is to use their existing lifetime spend as a quality measure for whether they're a VIP or not. So the way that you do this is you simply go down to predictive analytics about somebody, look at historical customer lifetime value. Don't look at total customer lifetime value because this is predicting what they'll spend in the future as well. Just look at historic customer lifetime value. And in this example, I'm going to use 500 as our number. So this will give me all the customers who've purchased, who have a lifetime spend of over $500. The second option is to create a list of customers based on how many purchases they've made. And so in this case, we're literally just saying that they have placed an order is at least, and in this example, I'll say 5. Our best customers spend buy five or more times, but you might just want to use 2 or 3, depending on how frequently your customers purchase. Go into settings, again under Facebook advertising, click choose an audience to sync with, and in this case, I'll create a new audience. Now that we have our most valuable customers, we want to find new customers on Facebook that look similar to those. So Facebook collects a lot of data about people and is able to profile them based on a number of different factors. And so what doing a lookalike audience does is it says to Facebook, please look at these existing customers. In this case, we know that they're our most valuable customers. And Facebook will find things that are similar between all of those customers and then try to find other people on Facebook who are similar to those existing people who have similar attributes. So it'll be looking at their demographics, their different app behavior, what type of things they're interested in on Facebook and Instagram and other networks, for example. So to do this, you take your source audience, the customers that you want Facebook to look at as your good, high value existing customers. So in this case, we'll use this Klaviyo audience too. Under actions, click create lookalike. You'll also need to select which country you want to limit it to or region. You can select multiple if you want. And then you can adjust how similar you want these customers to look to your original source customers. So you want this number to be, you know, sufficiently large that you'll reach a number of people. But the further out you go, the less they're going to look like your original customers. So in this case, I'm just going to start with 200,000. And then over time, I might expand that out if I want to reach more people and click create audience. And so now when you select your audience for your campaign to reach new customers, you select your lookalike audience and you'll exclude the original source audience. So that just makes sure that you're reaching new people and that you're not trying to advertise to your existing subscribers. Next, let's create a segment which will be for cross-channel promotion. So what this is when you send out an email campaign, it can also be really effective to run an ad campaign on Facebook that's got a similar, you know, an ad version of the email to the same audience. And so it's just increasing the effectiveness of the ads. Ads are shown to be 30% more effective when they're cross-channel. And so all we're gonna do here, create a list, go into segments. In this case, I'm gonna call it existing subscribers. And it will just be if they're in one of our VIP lists that we define. So they just need to be in one of them. So we just use the OR rule. And there we go. And so this will allow us to target customers in Facebook with the same ad campaign. And so then we know that they'll be seeing a similar message on multiple channels, which will be more effective. And so that's it for syncing audiences into Facebook to power up your Facebook marketing. Finally, I want to touch on lead ads, as I talked about. So lead ads are a special type of ad format within Facebook that allow you to have a sign up form within the Facebook experience. So someone scrolling through Facebook, they see the lead ad, they click on, you know, make an appointment or make an inquiry. It takes them to a form that loads up instantly, can have multiple choice. And the benefit of this is on the final sign up page, it will already have pre-filled their email address and name, either their email address and name that they have use on Facebook or ones that they've pre-filled for other lead ad forms in the past. So I'll show you how to connect this to Facebook in case you really just here to find out how to connect lead ads. So the first step is you need to have a lead form within Facebook before you connect it to Klaviyo. So under Facebook, go to create a campaign, select leads as your goal, and set up the rest of your campaign. And when you're setting up the ad itself, you'll have the option here to set up your instant form. So click create form, and it's got here all this preview stuff that I have already set up in the past, but you'll have the option here to modify the creative of the form, and then you can put in your questions as well. So you definitely need to have email address and full name, but you also have the option here to add multiple choice, short answer, conditional, and appointment request details as well. Now what we're interested here is obviously connecting this to Klaviyo, so we want to make sure that we're connecting to email as well. So let's call this our Klaviyo sync form and we'll save that. When you're setting up your form, you'll have to add a headline. You have to put in a description. I'll just put in this placeholder. You'll also need to put in your privacy policy. and your homepage website URL. This will be the final call to action. So now when we look at this form, we've got a really simple form, which is the intro, the submit your details, the privacy policy, and the successful completion. But you can obviously add more stages to this as well. I'm just using this for illustrative purposes. So now we can save and publish. And as with Facebook ads, usually you can share, you can send a notification to your own Facebook so that you can see what the ad looks like and test it all like that. So now that we've got that in place, let's go back to Klaviyo. So within Klaviyo, now we want to make a list that we can receive those leads from the Facebook ads to. So we go create a list. Let's call it Facebook leads. Create the list. So now we've got our empty list. Now we go into settings. As usual, I recommend, if you've seen my other videos, you know that I recommend changing this to single opt-in. But most importantly, now we've got this section here, which is the list is not currently connected to a Facebook lead ad. So we click here to connect to a lead ad. And you'll see here, I've already got Klaviyo sync form in here. And so now we can click that one and click update. And then we update our list settings. And so now this list will start to receive Facebook leads and they'll come through in real time. And so what that means is that you can now take this list, this source list of Facebook leads, and trigger a welcome series off it, for example, and include this in your newsletter campaigns. It makes it a very simple process for customers who are using Facebook to go to a lead ad page, submit their details, and now they're on the list. Okay, so that's how you do it. But what I usually recommend instead to my clients is that they build a landing page on their own site instead. And here's an example from Rolly, where they've set up a mobile landing page that includes a sign-up form, but it also allows them to promote other parts of the website as well and encourages customers to stay on the website. Whereas the challenge with Facebook lead ads sometimes is that customers will submit the details and then close the lead ad and then continue on in Facebook. Whereas really most of the time you kind of want them to spend more time on your website instead. So you need to weigh up for yourself which option is going to be better for you as to whether you use lead ads or you use a landing page on your site. Cool, and that's it. So that's how you make the most of the Facebook to Klaviyo integration. In this video, I've discussed connecting your Klaviyo lists and segments as audiences into Facebook, how to create lookalike audiences, and strategically how you can use that to attract customers who are most likely to be really high value compared to your old customers, how to re-engage your past customers, how to do cross-promotion campaigns, and how to make lookalike audiences. I also showed you how to connect a Facebook lead ad to a Klaviyo list so that you can nurture customers in real time. Thanks for watching this video. If you're interested in other things to do with, especially with Klaviyo, then check out our other video on list growth using the Klaviyo pop-up or making amazing audiences with segments in Klaviyo. Thanks for watching, bye.